I just look like I'm fucking crazy, but I'm not crazy. I don't know why he's letting me.
She was great from the start. Was no love like ours. Cooked my food, gave massage. Constantly sucked me off. Broke up, came back again. She's mentally scarred. Borderlines, call it splitting. Grappling with decisions. She's hot, then she's cold. Then she's tired of living. She's cutting her wrist again. Riding my dick again. That shit crazy, borderline women. Look for codependent men. Difficult to comprehend. We broke up yesterday. Now she wants me back again. Borderline personality. Worse mental disease. She said she's done with me. She called me back, please. I hate you, please don't leave me. Using sex for her was easy. To block me from seeing. She's so goddamn needy. These women are crazy, believe me. Sex on impulse. Suck a stranger off. Then convince the man it was all his fault. Avoid these type of women at all costs. Borderline personality. These women are scarred and lost.
Most of her is from being raised without a dad. One minute she cool, next minute she sad. Deeply rooted fear of abandonment. Gaslighting the kids with the same mindset. Don't accept wrongs, no accountability. Time to cut her off, she like, please don't leave me. I found out the relationship was a waste of time. Almost impossible to heal a borderline. She's a borderline, yeah.
But black men marry outside of their race more than every other group of men per capita.
And I'm not.
On some level, it can be insulting to our sisters.
Okay.
I consider it insulting to the community as a whole. As someone who works in the school, I've had to entertain conversations with black girls who are asking Dr. Umar, is there something wrong with me?
Shalom, brothers and sisters, I am Kahan Tazadaq. I am a spokesman for men and women that love them. Welcome to AS4M Show. Another broadcasting coming through the voice of Yahuwah's man, Kahan Tazadaq. And so, you've noticed over the dispensation of time that there's been a paradigm shift. You have black women, Hispanic women, damn near all women emulating white women. Yet black women as dark as night, down near here blonde. Now we understand that when there's a recessive gene and both parents, black people can definitely produce babies that's really dark with blonde hair, blue eyes, green eyes. But it's when the recessive genes meet. Now, I'm not a medical doctor. You can go and check this out for yourself. I'm not a geneticist. But you can check these things out for yourself. So why do we have these women wanting to look other than themselves? Now, to be right and exact, when we look in the book of Leviticus, the 13th and 14th chapter, the blonde hair was considered to be a curse, referred to as leprosy, when the hair turns all white. Now, I want to make this abundantly clear. This is not to make anyone feel degraded. It's to bring forth truth. This video, I'm citing examples only to facilitate right knowledge and truth. And so if you detach your emotions and try to listen logically, then you will walk away with something from this. Now, I know this is going to be exceedingly difficult for women, and this is not an attack on women. I'm not a misogynist. I'm a realist. But women usually are affected more by emotions than logic. It's not intended to infuriate you, but it's the way that it is. Now, so the reason you're seeing these women with the blonde hair, I mean, and it, It's like you're suffering from an identity crisis. If you're done, you're here blind. And you weren't born that way. And you don't have the capacity for ever growing your hair blind. Then why would you do it? Because it's unrealistic. It's like you stepped off into this cartoon world. Or did you really? Or was this psychologically engineered? Did it come from a place of self-discontent? Or it may be even suffice to say self-hate. So you have the Hispanic women that dye their hair blonde, the dark-skinned black women that dye their hair blonde, and light-skinned black women that dye their hair blonde, emulating Karen. Emulating Karen. But why? No one stops to ask why. And when you point this out to these women, they become highly offended. Why? Because the truth will make you mad. Wise man in Florida once told me, he said, yo, come on, Tazadaq, when the truth is spoken, two things occur. Laughter, silence. That wise man was named Kadar. And I find him to be right and exact. They either laugh because it indicates a form of nervousness, or they go silent because they don't know what to say. When the truth comes, or false things must disappear. So we have these women swimming in a pool of self-hate. Heck, I mean, you hear how they even alter their accents. Now, education doesn't require one to alter their accents, right?
I know a lot of people take issue with my beliefs. I'm white. I'm a Caucasian because everything about me is different from an African-American. I have naturally straight hair. My hair isn't nappy. It doesn't require weave. My nose is not giant like African-Americans. My lips are perfect. They're not too big and they're not too small. Like, they're just perfect. My ears, I don't have black people ears because they're really giant. Most African-Americans speak ghetto. But when it comes to black people, I think they're all ugly and I have nothing in common with them. I'm different from African-Americans.
Why is it that black women that so-called go off to college, they alter their accents? You guys hear me, right? Sometimes I speak broken English. Obviously, I could change that, but hey, that's a part of my culture. That's a part of our culture. That's a part of our heritage, speaking in such a way. It's kind of synonymous to Jamaican speaking patois. What? I mean, you know, the Jamaican slang. It was designed for a reason. And all of the hip talk that you come, that you hear people using around the world, it came from us. It's because we're those kind of people. We have swag. So now you have white people using the broken English and so on and so forth.
I hate being black.
I refuse to accept a life where I'm forced to view my existence as unbearable. A narrative not only crafted, but also upheld by prejudicial laws and social norms from those who harbor ill will towards me or that bore that same feeling towards my ancestors.
Well, if you even have the famous people, the so-called, ruling class using that language at times because they realize that we are such a unique people and everyone knows it except for us. Why is that? I contend that it was plotted to be that way. And so when they attempt to speak down on me, well, what does he sound like that? Oh, he has a speech impediment. I could speak as they would actually like me to speak. And in the appropriate form, I tend to do so. But I'm for the people, my people. That really needs help. I'm the voice of the hood. I'm here to represent the hood, to show you what you could do if you put your mind to it, and no one could stop you even if they tried. Get out of the way. Because there is an intellectualized freight train of right knowledge coming your way. And if you don't want this right knowledge, you will get ran over. So get out of the way. And get on the sideline, because this is a revolution of truth, and they don't want the truth to be there, because then the fallacies, the fabricated story, and your cartoon world will disappear. Go on, tell the doc so he knows, said it.
This heart-wrenching story of this young girl sort of despising her Black identity resonated so deeply with me. A feeling that I don't think anyone should ever have to deal with.
Because I'm white. My figure is just like Kim Kardashian, and she's a wonderful role model. I act and I think like a white person instead of a Black person.
I believe that I'm completely and utterly better than them. Like, we're on two different levels. Like, okay, African Americans are here, I'm here.
White people act and think just way more mature than African Americans. Black people, they think in a criminal way. When I think about African Americans, I feel like asking them, what is wrong with them? They're really dangerous. If African American is on the same street as I am, I'll cross the street to avoid their chaotic, thuggish way.
So it is our responsibility to teach our people the truth and our greatness. So what I want to talk to you today is about the gullah people and how many of you refer to them as Geechies and so on and so forth out of ignorance. And many of you people down there, you know, from those islands and on that coast, you don't know your true history. You don't know, you know, half of those words that you're utilizing is Hebrew. You know, you think you're Africans because, you know, that the place is named after so-called white, you know, conqueror. So, I mean, you think you're Africans. You don't know that you're Hebrews. And I want to say this before I begin to you Egyptologists. You're essentially byproducts of the Vatican, because the Vatican's confused, the Vatican actually confused you about the real truth. The concept of Egyptology that you guys are using today is information that is actually screened by the Vatican before it even gets to you. And they have much of our history hidden in that Vatican. Now, the question that I want you to reflect upon is, why does telling history of so-called Black people and you so-called Hispanics of a Negro descent offend people? You love your enemies and you therefore embrace them in your rank. The very system has been placed in place and systematically set into place to provoke what's going on in Chicago right now. Many of you, you have these people within your ranks. Now, the system of white supremacy and Black inferiority is actually promoted to prolong white genetic survival. And this is how a small percentage of people of the planet, approximately about 10%, has been able to control so many for so long. By blonde hair, blue eyes, so on and so forth, you know, so-called white woman being the most beautiful. They promote it on the silver screen. They promote it in ABC, NBC, CBS, all the major media networks. They promote white supremacy. If they was to tell the truth, then the history that brothers like me are compelled to come out with, they would have it out there in their media, on their silver screen, and in their history books. So they promote white supremacy, that white is most beautiful, and anything other than white is inferior, which is all actually causing you people to alter the texture of your hair, to get blonde extensions and to bleach your skin and so on and so forth, to promote and prolong genetic white survival, to prevent genetic white annihilation. Now, the problem with many of you Israelites is you have Esau within your ranks. And the reason being so is because you detest who you are. You detest who you are, and you cannot love your brethren and sisters because you detest who you are. Therefore, you know, since you hate yourself, you go out and you marry so-called white people. So then you twist the scriptures and you allow Edomites within your ranks to justify having them around you. You know, in the 1960s, the so-called Black man and Black woman was not divided as the so-called Black man and Black women are today. The Black woman has actually been seduced by the White Lesbian Liberations, the White Lesbian Women's Liberations Movement. And I'm going to tell you the truth, and you need to listen. You wanted to be free. You was never sisters. She was never sisters with you. Never. You wanted to be free. Free of your man. You don't want your man to tell you what to do like she did not want her man to tell her what to do. Now, the only time that many of you so-called black women really get along with your men is when you're laying down and spreading your legs. But as soon as you're done and you're back standing erect, you're at war with the so-called black man again. And this is the truth. And many of you brothers know that this is the truth. So stop being weak to these women. You don't comprehend, so-called black woman, that to destroy the black family, you must destroy the masculine principle. I'm not going to lie to you like these Egyptologists and many of these Moors are saying, oh, the woman's God. That's a damn lie, man. That's a damn lie. So to destroy a nation, you destroy the man because he is the head figure. He's the leader. He's the head. That's what true power comes from. Then you could go after the woman. Now, Natalie Filler, he said something that came to pass. In the 70s, he predicted, way back in the 70s, he predicted that this system of white supremacy would have black men wearing dresses. Now look at you. Look at how they got your damn comedians. They got them dressing up like women. My dear, Martin Lawrence and all of this, Sinead and all this madness. Many of you are just regularly in the streets. Now you cross-dress. You cross-dress that you consider yourself to be intelligent people. Well, if you're an intelligent people, you should be able to look at your sexual organ and determine what sex you are. You let your pants sag. You young boys that's been raised by these women. There's no men in the house. So the boy's raised by a woman, then he has femininity on him. He's effeminate. So he let his pants sag. Don't you know? That's alluding to, he's let his pants sag so his buttocks show. And eventually, the pants come all the way down and he put on a dress. And that's what it's come to. You homo thugs. That's what it's come to. Why? Because these young boys are being reared by women. Where's the man? You chased him out with your mouth. The black man is not there.
But black men marry outside of their race more than every other group of men per capita.
So the black family is being systematically destroyed. It has no head. This is genocide, people. You better wake up. Don't you know that the pediatricians are saying now that the feminization of the so-called black male children are an epidemic? The feminization of the so-called black male children are an epidemic, according to the pediatricians. Why is this? Because they're around too many women. Because they're around too many women. And all of them are not necessarily homosexuals, but they had that feminine spirit. Because they're around women all the time. So when they're around a strong masculine man, she say, oh, that's too aggressive. He's not used to it. So even those that go off to college and so on and so forth, he still act real sissy-like. There's no man in the home. And sisters, you might get mad, but you need to hear me. This is love. Sisters get mad because those of you that this is cutting, you know that it's true. But, sisters, if you don't need a man, and 72% of black homes are headed by a single parent being a black female, and the crime rate and homosexuality amongst black men, young black males, are staggering. I would say that you're in desperate need of a man. It wasn't like that when the so-called black man was in the home. You want to fix the problems that's going on in Chicago? All of this murdering? Well, you humble yourself, sisters, and you submit to your authority. Now, living in Esau's world over this time, that's going to be exceedingly difficult for many of you. You humble yourself and you get a righteous man in that home. Now, I know you don't like this talk. Now, a psychologist came up with, now watch this. I'm going to show you how many of you sisters will put your young black male, your young black son, on psych drugs or what have you, or classify him as, functional illiterate, or saying that he's dysfunctional. So you could get, what do they call that thing? Disability. So you could get a disability check. You do this, and it's mostly done to the male children. The same as Pharaoh had a death control plan to destroy the so-called black man when the Messiah was to come to birth. It's going on today. But you're not intelligent enough to see behind the facade of deception, of handshakes and smiles, of hugs, of a job. You women are going to have to stop sending your children to special ed, destroying these children's lives when nothing is usually wrong with them. And guess what? It's mostly the so-called young black men. You can't talk about a black agenda, brothers and sisters, and not discuss these matters of white supremacy. No one wants to talk about that. You want to sweep that up on the rug and pretend it doesn't exist. If you pretend that white supremacy does not exist, you are aiding to the destruction of our people. You've been miseducated, and it's time that you admit that. And this is one key factor of the black-on-black crime and the violence that's going on in Chicago. Miseducation. If you're not properly educated, then you don't get quality jobs. So over 50% of so-called black men in New York City, in Philadelphia, and Baltimore are unemployed. So with the unemployment rate, the crime rate increases. Increase of crime due to decrease in jobs. So crime amongst the so-called black man escalates. And the social scientists, they study this and they know it. So brothers and sisters, this is an appeal to you Israelites, to you Moors, to you nations of gods and earth, to the nation of Islam, to you Egyptologists, to you Black Panthers, to you Brown Berets, to you Nuwabians, and to you pro-black brothers and sisters. You know, I have witnessed you repress yourselves and repress your power by battling each other over the years. Is it any wonder that we as a people are powerless? You know, the likelihood of you being from the same nation is more than not. You are prolonging the rulership of white supremacy by beating down each other. We are now our own worst enemies. You've been trained to do that way. Prior to the 70s, our women were in accord with us and accepted us as their head. Yet the white liberation movement poisoned their minds, and now the so-called black men and black women are mortal enemies. You so-called Hispanics, many of you in that same situation. So the white power structure, they delight in your self-destruction. If you're an intelligent people, and I contend that you are, once you discover who you once were and your primary objective, it is time to unify, brothers and sisters. It is time to unify that power, to do for self. What will it take to wake us up? You don't know your potential. You don't know. So, you know, with that being said, you know, these black-on-black crimes, about 75% of it is economically based. About 75%. This is a systematic plan that is actually designed by a hidden hand. Now, the lack of employment, as I previously stated, is contextual relevant of this black-on-black crime and murder. So with less jobs, there's an influx of violence. More jobs, less violence. Those of you that study the science of criminology, you know this. The white social scientists know this. But as long as you're dysfunctional Hebrews battling another camp, Moors battling the Hebrews, Nation of Islam battling the Moors, Nations of Gods and Earths battling the Nubians and so on and so forth, well, more than likely, all of you point right back to the same nation. You cannot agree on a damn thing. Then we are finished. But Esau, he's agreed on one thing, that he must stay in power and keep you confused. So what? They say, we got a problem, but we're going to keep these NBCs beneath us. The Tea Party are the immigrants and conquerors that divided you here in North America. Now, back in the day, they had another name. I think it was called a Ku Klux Klan. Now, once again, the only time many of you black women get along with your man now is when your legs are spread. Then once you're back up, you're battling him again. You don't want a head. You're under this liberation madness. That's one of our main problems. Many of your young boys are effeminized because they're raised around too many women. Now, I don't give a damn that you, many of you sisters, you ain't gonna like this, but I'm gonna tell the truth, and you can't stomach the truth because you got your head so far up the white man's rectum for a job, and because he has the best cars, the best homes, and so on and so forth, you humble yourself when it's time to him. Come when it's time for him. If he tells you to be to work at a certain time, you're gonna do it. Because you know the consequences is you're not gonna have a job and you're not gonna get your nose done. So you listen to him. But if your husband at home tells you to do something, nigga, you don't tell me what to do. I'm grown. My father raised me. And I'm not gonna let no man raise me again. You out of order, sis. You're out of order. You're out of order. So you're feminizing these boys because they're around too many women. And even if he goes off to college, he's still effeminized. And then you sisters, many of you, you're falling in love with your own image. Effeminate, sissy, weak men. That's the image that you're falling in love with. This is the truth. This is the truth. And the so-called black man, his mind is so messed up. Many of you Negroes are messed up. If he gets a well-to-do job, he wants a so-called white woman. Because he suffers so much from self-loathing that he's taught, if he reached the top, to get a top choice woman, it has to be a white woman. Or one of these other women of the other nation. You don't have time for the so-called black woman anymore. The average so-called black man's mind is messed the hell up. So the problem with the so-called black man, those of you that don't have jobs, is you want to set up all damn day. Your wife's out working and you playing video games with your son all damn day. Then she tells you, Negro, get up and do something. But the truth is, the man may have tried. He may have tried and he was rejected. He may have a degree or skill. But if he's connected to his culture, that cannot survive in the world of white supremacy. You have to feminize yourself and cater to their ways. You have to alter your accent and become effeminized and a yes man. Don't you dare to show any strength. Negro, you better humble yourself. And many of you, you know I'm telling the truth. But you're just not strong enough to say this the way that I'm saying it. So instead of uniting with other black men and saying, listen, brother, we got to do it for ourselves. We have to pool our resources. You got this skill. Yakanan got that skill. Shael got this skill. Let's combine this and do for self. If I need this, I know this brother got this skill. He a mechanic. this brother over here, he cuts hair. You pool your resources and keep the money within the community. But he can't do that because they're divided by names. They're divided over groups. They're divided over titles. And some of you no good dirty dogs, you can't keep your eyes off of the next brother's wife because you're wicked as hell. Many of you men, you're wicked as hell. And many of you, I'm going to hit you with something. Many of you just become Israelites so you could take 2, 3, 4 wives and then don't do for none of them. Because you're a low good, you're a low down, no good dirty dog. Many of you. So, honor yourselves and stand up and be women of God, sisters. And we need to stop begging for jobs and coalesce and create our own. It's essential to survive. This society is coming to an end. The American dollar is almost finished. We must unite and invest. We got to come together, folks. Now, right now, how many of you know that 40% of college grads are forced to move back in with their parents and default on student loans? 40%. You need to know your history. Many of our people do not know their history, so they feel like nothing, think that they're nothing, and if they always, you know, have that perception of themselves, they would never be something, but never be anything. Now, our people don't know, most of you don't know that, you know, a so-called black man created the Russian language, Alexander Pushkin. They don't know that. They don't know that Angelo Solomon, you know, and obviously from his name, he was a Hebrew, but Moors like to say that he was a Moor, was the father of, you know, masonry. Many of you don't know that, and Beethoven was a so-called black man. So, brothers and sisters, what this video essentially is about
is to encourage our people to return to their respective roles. The Most High dealt with a patriarch. When the Most High created Adam and then Eve, he dealt with a marital hierarchy. A marital hierarchy was produced at creation, where the husband was the loving exercise of authority over his wife, and his wife was to respectfully submit to her husband. Yahuwah, Most High Adonai, designed men to provide for and to protect their wives in the book of Bereshit, also referred to in the Greek word Genesis 2 and 15. And he designed women to be helpers, not equals, not smart mouths, but helpers to their husbands in the book of Bereshit, Genesis 2 and 18. These views are of Genesis, the beginning. The fall captures these relationships and are introduced with strife between the husband and the wife. Ever since Eve yielded to High Satan, she's been at strife with her husband, her man, her head, her leader. Sin has corrupted everything, including marriage. But this is marital strife, specifically foretold by Adonai in Bereshit. In Genesis 3 and 16, when the Most High pronounced judgment against Eve, he said to her, "Your desires shall be contrary to your husband's, but he shall rule over you." Bereshit 3 and 16, Genesis 3 and 16. See, the difficulty of this verse has actually led to several interpretations. There are Christians today who argue that there was no hierarchy between man and a woman prior to the fall. Part of the view known as egalitarianism. Yes, egalitarianism. They want to make women and men equal. However, a Musean hierarchy and male headship were part of the creation. And there are three possible views the Most High pronounced in Bereshit, Genesis 3 and 16. It reaffirms the creation of the marital hierarchy as a continual blessing. Describe the perversion of the marital rules, or predict the wife will desire to escape the husband's authority, but prescribe that the husband must exercise godly rule to restrain his wife. Thus saith the Most High. So I encourage all women, if you truly want to be happy, if you truly want to feel content and free, return to the role that Adonai Elohim has designed for you, which is to be not a leader of your husband, not a leader of men, but a helper of your husband, a helpmeet, and to be submissive. This is how you will get what you want out of this life. Anything else is the indoctrination of Satan. So I question the efficacy of your modern day edumacation, because it's contrary to the Most High. I'm Kahan Tazadaq, a spokesman for men and women that love them. If you like this video, give a donation to keep truths like this keep coming. If this video offended you, obviously I meant to, because it's only through your emotions can we provoke change. Return to your position and we will return to ours. Know who you are in this earth. I'm Kahan Tazadaq, and this is my view of you and my reality. A spokesman for men and women that love them. Like, share, subscribe, donate.